Anger is simply a certain level of intensity. If you're angry, your energies are intense. If you're not, your energies are low-key. There is no such thing as righteous anger. It's simply a psychological drama that people adopt to make themselves feel strong.
You will not be punished for your anger. You will be punished by your anger.
Anger is not an empowering process. It is not a tremendous possibility.
Holding on to anger is like grasping a hot coal. With the intent of throwing it at someone else, you are the one who gets burned.
Anger is a product of what you have identified yourself with.
Anger will never disappear, so long as thoughts of resentment are cherished in the mind. Anger will disappear just as soon as thoughts of resentment are forgotten.
Anger is a consequence of your inability to manage your own system.
Conquer anger by love, conquer evil by good. Conquer the miser with generosity, conquer the liar with truth.
Anger is not a good thing. It clouds the mind, and the situation you create from anger never leave you in a good place.
Do not be led by others. Awaken your own mind. Amass your own experience and decide for yourself your own path.
If you know anger, you will know all aspects of life. If you transcend anger, you will live a glorious life.
One who remains indifferent to both the ups and downs of worldly circumstances attains equanimity and lives happily.
Anger is not because of something. Anger is the nature of who you are right now.
In a controversy, the instant we feel anger, we have already ceased striving for the truth and have begun striving for ourselves.
Anger is just a surface phenomenon. It takes a lot to be angry, but it takes even more to be loving, to be gentle.
Better than 1,000 hollow words is one word that brings peace.
Anger, resentment, hatred are poisons that you drink, but you expect somebody else to die.
Hatred does not cease through hatred at any time. Hatred ceases through love. This is an unalterable law.
If you realize that anger is a foolish thing, it will drop.
When one has the feeling of dislike for evil, when one feels tranquil, one finds pleasure in listening to good teachings. When one has these feelings and appreciates them, one is free of fear.
Anger is not about what is happening around you. It is about what is happening within you.
By doing this, hostility is overcome by non-hostility. This is the teaching of Buddha.
If you're angry, you will become ugly. That's what anger does to you.
Not to do any evil, to cultivate good, to purify one's mind. This is the teaching of the Buddha.
Anger is not strength. Anger is a tremendous weakness.
He abused me. He struck me. He overpowered me. He robbed me. Those who harbor such thoughts do not still their hatred.
When there is no anger, there is no hatred. And when there is no hatred, there is no violence. This is the way to create a violence-free society.
Respond to every call that excites your spirit.
Anger is not about somebody else. It is about you lacking the necessary poise and balance to manage a situation.
Do not dwell in the past. Do not dream of the future. Concentrate the mind on the present moment.
Anger is a very compulsive state of passion. It is a preserved kind of pleasure in it.
As rain does not break through a well-thatched house, so passion will not break through a well-reflecting mind.
Anger is simply your inability to manage your own system.
Endurance is one of the most difficult disciplines, but it is to the one who endures that the final victory comes.
Anger is a tool that people use to enhance their identity. Anger is not power.
Silence the angry man with love. Silence the ill-natured man with kindness. Silence the miser with generosity. Silence the liar with truth.
If you're really angry, you don't get anything. Your body becomes so tense. Your mind becomes so clouded. You will do all the wrong things.
A disciplined mind brings happiness.
Your anger is your making. Your joy is your making.
You
yourself, as much as anybody in the entire universe, deserve your love and affection.